Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Call of Cthulhu. Where were we? Ah, yes, the Nameless Bookstore. Ding! Hope everyone's having a fantastic night. And, yeah. Let's just get right on into it. Chapter 7, The Nameless Bookstore. The Shambler turned out to be much more than an artwork painted by Sarah Hawkins, as a huge creature came out of the painting to attack Pierce. After a hard fight, the detective managed to send it back into the painting. He later discovered that the dagger he used to repel the creature had been sold to Sanders by a man named Algernon Drake, owner of the Nameless Bookstore. Pierce decides to pay the little library a visit. Also, on a side note, I have these new Lay's Crispy Taco Chips, and they are so good. Like, they are delicious. Almost as good as the fried green onion ones. Well, fried green tomato ones, I should say. Ding! Hello, Mr. Pierce. Oh, there's blood.
Where is the bookseller?
No idea.
Freud's thing? The Interpretation of Dreams. It's the work that laid the foundations of psychoanalysis at the beginning of this century.
It was practical work, but written by Sigmund Freud for a psychologist. Describes the techniques of analytical interpretation of dreams. The analysis must follow several rules, especially that of free association, a principle announced by Freud at the end of the 19th century. It treats dreams as a way of revealing buried desires. I cannot believe this theory is applicable to my nightmares. Oh, medicine. Yay. Probably a lot of skill progression books in here, huh?
Another volume of the Reverend's wife's diary.
The pastor declared himself to be the prophet. He renounced God and worshipped a strange pagan entity with a monstrous appearance. His wife tried to reason with her husband, but in vain. He was convinced that he must listen to this voice in his head because it holds the truth. Uh-oh. Bad times for the pastor's wife. Darkwater History by Harry Kemp. A Puritan colony, led by revered John Wickwood, settled on the island during the 17th century. They named the island Darkwater because of the dark shades of the sea. They believed it was because of the peculiar color of the rocks surrounding the island. They erected the first buildings, among which were the Hawkins Manor, the church, and the cemetery. The rare documents and handwritten notes they left spoke of nightmares and deviant behaviors. They disappeared at the beginning of the 18th century. I noticed that says Volume 2. Did I ever find Volume 1? I swear, I'm going to have to go through and take a look at some of the things I have. Also, notice the bar didn't show up. Oh well. Even a few years back, it was possible for a single practitioner to know all the medical knowledge of his time. This book, which concludes the series, shows that this is now virtually impossible. About 10 renowned doctors took part in putting together this collection. Okay, how's my medicine looking? Do I have it? I have so many character points. Oh boy. Well, we're just gonna max out investigation, aren't we? Any hidden objects? Human behavior. To spot hidden. Ding. How's my sanity? I am shaken. Me to the shambler. For a second, I thought that looked like a fucking skeleton. Cultist symbol, discreet tribe, ally speechstrom, sleeping cultist? Eh. Lot of shit there. A hurricane lamp. Jesus. Okay. Handbook on Anatomy and Dissection. As precise and illustrated with as much detail as the first volume, this book focuses on healing surgeries specific to malformation and motor disorders. Hey! More medicines. Man, my medicine is going up so slowly. I really should have put a lot of points into those to begin with. If I ever play this game a second time, I'm definitely going to put all my points into medicine and occult. Because I am getting character points out the wazoo for everything else. What's this? Oh, oil. Okay, sweet. Not that I've ever... Not that I really ever use my hurricane lamp. I feel like I don't need it. Is that an infant? Hmm. Oh, someone likes chess. Ooh. Did they check my thinking? They did indeed. History of Darkwater. In the 19th century, as the American whaling industry reached its peak in the rest of the world, whales gradually disappeared from the waters surrounding Darkwater. This phenomenon appears even more mysterious because, up until then, the region was a favored refuge for cetaceans. In 1847, after months of pursuit, Scylla returns to port with a gigantic creature on board. Its crew asserts that the sea monster had eaten all the disappeared whales. After a night of ferocious combat, the survivors managed to drag the beast onto the whaling ship. I want to know what the fuck they dragged aboard, because it doesn't sound like a whale at all. And where am I going?
Ah, what happened here?
There we go. Ooh. Well, damn it. I'm actually surprised no one's joined.
Where did they break in from? Blood.
Probably here.
Seems like amateur work. Someone tall left this footprint. A man, probably. This burglar seems to be rather clumsy.
Nope, no clue there. I'm so glad I don't have to deal with a shambler, though. Oh? Is that a safe in a cold?
What happened that made the burglar flee before finishing? What sort of thief leaves his tools at the crime scene? What killed all these animals?
I don't want to look at it. Oh boy.
What the? Charles Hawkins? Looks like the symbol rejected Hawkins. Where did I see it? What sort of power did Sarah Hawkins' painting possess?
Ah!
Carol Hawkins helped hide something in this safe.
Well, I mean, I can break it open.
Drake put in a great deal of effort to hide whatever is in here. Everything is linked to the Sarah Hawkins case.
Ding. Oh dear. It's a combo lock. Great.
Drake left instructions on how to find the combination of his safe.
A page seems to be hidden here. It is possible to read. If somebody finds these memoirs, there will be no doubt that I am in serious trouble. My last and only hope is that my body and bones are still in this plane of reality, in order that they be recovered and burned. The funeral urn must be given to my dear mother, if she is still of this world. The following message is of capital importance. Whoever reads these lines and demonstrates acuity as sharp as mine can hope to gain access to my most precious possession. It lies within my safe, and the clues to the combination are to be found in three cylinders, each hidden where life and study combine in the Greek world. Each cylinder is numbered, even if, as the celebrated Arthur says, order is the pleasure of reason, but disorder is the delight of the imagination. Indeed, despite my preference for organized chaos, I must admit that reason usually prevails in the end. If, by chance, a person, or should I say a genius, was to match my intellect and find the combination of the safe, I would ask that they deliver its content into the safekeeping of my friend and colleague, Professor Armitage of Miskatonic University. The content of this safe is not only a vast digest of knowledge, but also a weapon that is far too dangerous for it to fall into the wrong hands. I hope that you will be able to appreciate the danger that this represents, and that you will act accordingly. In any event, I will neither be there to guide you, nor to suffer you from your actions. Okay. The least that can be said about this book is that its title is well conceived. The illustrations of human anatomy and dissection methods presented are illustrated in great detail. You have to have a strong heart or the detachment proper to doctors to consult its pages. Oh, hello.
A strange amulet.
What are you?
I have a feeling I'd better not touch it.
Strange amulet. The pendant is in the shape of a large dog. I don't know what it represents. I might have to find out more by searching the bookstore. Oh, yay, a cult.
What link did he find between Charles Hawkins and an old amulet?
The key of Erdlia file. This key, that bears the Elder sign, is the only one able to protect your psyche. It is in the form of a cylindrical medallion, hanging at the end of a heavy chain. Hundreds of years ago, the star and the branch, whose purpose it is to push back the forces of the great old ones, were engraved at its center. Everything points to it being Charles Hawkins that tore it from its last owner, an Egyptian antique dealer. In press cuttings that mention the misdemeanor, the date of the robbery coincides with the last of Hawkins' trips off to Cario. It remains to be seen whether he knows of the true purpose of the artifact. Try to find it.
Is everyone on this island taking sleeping pills?
Well, quite possibly. Okay, so we've got to find the combination. I'm tempted to just start guessing. Oh my dear God, there's everything now.
Okay. Arkham Editions. Never heard of them.
Book of Esoteric Philosophy and a key text in Madame Blavatsky's Theosophical Movement, written by Helena Petrovna Blavatsky. This volume is part of the Arkham Anthology, a luxurious collection of treatises and works on esotericism and the supernatural. Wow, that was...
How many volumes are there in this collection?
Oh dear God, Azathoth and Other Horrors. A collection of poems by Edward Pickman Derby, also known as Nightmare Lyrics, this collection of poems was sensationally received when first published in 1908. Derby was only 18 years old. This volume is part of the Arkham Anthology, a luxurious collection of...
Another volume by Arkham Editions.
Jesus Christ. A book of spells supposedly written by the legendary King Solomon. It contains various rituals of invocation and rituals of curse. Reedition by Claudia D. Waite, based on L.W. DeLawrence's original. Yep, part of the...
Arkham editions? Never heard of them.
A collection of long-term astrological predictions written in verse. Written by Nostradamus, translated by Ilyanoe and Theophilus Widebridge.
How many volumes are there in this collection?
Oh,
another volume by Arkham Editions.
Opera in 8 Acts by Benvenuto Chieti? Bird di Cera. Oh, wow, that's a name. An infamous lyrical work published in Italy in 1768. It is said that the opera was performed only once, resulting in an audience riot that left several dead and missing.
Arkham Editions?
Jesus fucking Christ. An ancient Frisian manuscript translated by William R. Sandbach. The text claims that in the distant past, Europe and other continents were controlled by the mothers of this people, and moreover, that our alphabet is still derived from the Frisian language.
How many volumes are there in this collection?
Apparently a lot. A collection of essays on American folklore and urban legends, written by Albert Wilmoth. Professor at Miskatonic University.
Another volume by Arkham Editions.
Written by Hermes Trismegistus, translated and edited by Nathaniel E. Coppelius. This collection of texts on different beliefs was written by a legendary philosopher. It includes a translation of the Emerald Tablet, a popular text among 16th century alchemists. Okay, cool. That's a lot of books. Hello.
Cylinders that Drake tried to hide. I should perhaps listen to them.
Yeah, you should, but there's also one more. Would I read the book?
What does this strange book contain? This book contains unholy knowledge.
This collection catalogues and classifies creatures that I had never heard of. Divinities from the stars, creatures capable of travelling from one dimension to another. It presents itself as the reference work on the bestiary of the myth, without giving details on the mythology to which it refers. Its pages are covered with phantasmagorical illusions. I feel like my sanity just went down some. But hey, occultism went up. I am indeed shaken.
Things are not looking good.
No, they weren't. But if Cthulhu ever plays me in a... Oh, I found all three. Okay.
And these red rocks, like precious stones, lie fixed, set in divine gold. To be the guardian of the Grail does not protect me from its attractions, Henry. And I do confess it. I am willing to pay to know its secrets. I finally understood that we were only pieces on the chessboard of the gods. Let those of us who are still standing protect our White Queen from their dark soldiers. I see our number dwindling, and my will strengthens as my apprehension grows. We shall refuse to be the playthings of destiny. Dear friend, I thank you again for the anthology of the works of Arkham Editions that you sent me. Volume 9, Azathoth and Other Horrors, seemed particularly relevant to my research. I never tire of browsing through them.
Soldiers protecting the White Queen.
And these red drops, like precious stones, lie fixed, set in divine gold. To be the guardian of the Grail does not protect me from its attractions, Henry. And I do confess it. I am willing to pay to know its secrets.
Okay. Okay. So first off, the White Queen.
So these are the volumes that Drake was talking about in his message.
Did I get it? Holy shit, I fucking did it. I took a complete guess at the first one. Nice. Go me. I do want to find that grail, though. Go away, run! Uh-oh. Again with the fucking Riverside Institute! In the Nameless Bookstore, Pierce traced the trail of the attempted burglary. He discovered that Charles Hawkins was behind the attempt. Pierce opened the books of the safe to find out what the ladder and Sarah Hawkins had hidden there. A book covered in human skin lied inside. Irresistibly attracted the detective. When he opened it, his mind was projected into another body. His mind was projected into another body. God fucking damn it, who am I? And why am I back at the Institute? I wonder just how much longer this game is. I've heard it was relatively short, but who knows? Perhaps it is longer than I wish.
Dr. Colden, this man's condition is deteriorating.
What says Dr. Fuller? It's his patient, after all.
He's busy with Captain Fitzroy. He specifically asked us not to bother him when that's the case.
Oh, of course. I'll see what I can do. Mr. Blake, Can you hear me? I'm Dr. Colden. We'll take care of you.
There's nothing
we can
do.
Oh, we're Dr. Colden. Okay.
I tried talking to him. He's catatonic.
Did you inject him with a tranquilizer?
No, Doctor. Not me, not anyone. Our stock is empty yet again.
Again? But there was enough for the whole island.
More and more people are suffering from insomnia. We can't refuse to help.
Of course.
Any idea what this man might be undergoing?
Let's examine him.
I'll examine him. Severe malnutrition. Swollen abdomen with traces of petechia. Doesn't seem like an edema. Slight protuberances seem to indicate the presence of a foreign body. 30-year-old subject. Severe hypothermia. Erythematous papules around the eyes and eardrums. Necrosed palpebral tissue. Lord, this smell. His skin shows abnormal loss of color and seems dried out. He's totally dehydrated. His fingertips and toes seem to feature a slight ring under the skin. Tender at the touch. Slightly sticky.
So, Doctor, an opinion?
I'm not sure I have the necessary knowledge to treat this man.
Don't say that. You're our most worthy doctor after Dr. Fuller.
Some of his symptoms are beyond my comprehension.
What did you find?
The state of his limbs is worrisome.
In spite of the muscle contractions, his arms seem limp.
Yes. They can't have decalcified, not at this rate.
And yet...
Hey, Azzy, how are
you? If there is a bone in this arm, it's softer than that of a newborn baby. What about his cranium?
It's soft at the touch. It does seem like the skull of a baby.
Look at these sticky rings growing at his fingertips. What can be happening?
I'm sure you'll find an explanation. You have to.
He is severely dehydrated.
I see signs of hypodermoclysis, but he's still dehydrated. When was his last IV?
He's constantly under perfusion. I've even gone beyond the recommended dose to no avail. And you won't believe me, but when we bathed him earlier...
He seemed to feel better?
Yes. Like he needs an aquarium, not a perfusion. But that doesn't explain his condition.
Well, if you know anything about the Cthulhu lore, my dear, the fact that he's growing sticky rings under his fingers and seems to want to live in the water, he's turning into an Innsmouth villager. He is absolutely turning into a Cthulhu monster.
Did you examine his abdomen? It would seem there's something inside.
He hasn't eaten in days. Are you certain it's not an edema?
No. Can't you recognize an edema? Pushing with your finger won't leave a trace. And look at these bumps.
It's not like he could be pregnant.
Whatever it is, this man has something inside him that shouldn't be there. We should operate on him at once.
Dr. Fuller said not to worry, that the edema would go away by itself.
You know... I'm not sure Dr. Fuller is telling the truth.
His body is mutated.
I almost don't believe it myself, but these symptoms are not those usually associated with the human species.
What do you mean? Don't tell me you believe in extraterrestrials.
No, I believe in old ones.
This poor man is from our world, all right. But his body is undergoing unnatural mutations. And this transformation is killing him. His body simply can't cope.
Where could he have gotten such an infection?
I pray that it's not here.
Dr. Colden, may I know what you're doing to my patient?
What I'm doing? How about what you've done to him?
Let us calm down, my dear Marie. I don't appreciate your tone, nor your insinuations. I've done to him what I do to all my patients, provide him with the best available care.
Your imagination is without limit. It's your homemade drug again, is it not? Those people are not your guinea pigs.
There, there. What have you seen to put you in such a state?
These symptoms
these
are worrisome.
These are alarming symptoms. If we don't act, he'll die.
Do you believe that? I'm not as convinced, you see. I even think this man has a strong chance of completely healing from his ailments.
No, Doctor. This patient isn't himself anymore. He's dying.
Really? What do you mean by isn't himself?
He's changing. His physical characteristics, they are more animal than human now.
Fascinating. An animal, you say? Could you be more precise? Cephalopod, perhaps.
This amuses you.
Your reaction does. I know your thirst for knowledge, Doctor. It's your innocent worries for this man that have you overreacting.
For this man, and the others whose medical files you've been hiding.
I have to protect my discovery. These people owe me their life, but the world isn't ready yet. It will be, in time.
I will not let you do this.
You disappoint me, Marie, but I still have hope you'll one day share my point of view. In the meantime, take care of your own patients and try not to forget who you're dealing with.
Was that a threat?
Oh dear.
What did he mean?
It was a warning. Dr. Fuller is this institution's founder and one of our profession's most influential voices. My word is of no weight against his. If I continue to protest, I will only ruin my reputation and career.
It's scandalous. Can't we do anything? Is there no evidence of his crimes?
Hidden files?
Oh, that evidence exists. I'm sure of it. I need to find the missing medical files.
And where would you find those? In his office. What if you get caught?
I'd rather not think about that. I'm counting on your discretion.
Of course, Doctor. You can count on me. I'll keep Mum.
I have to get to Fuller's office. I'm not sure I know where
that is. Hay fever. What's he doing here?
Doctor, please, my chest, oh.
His perfusion of a semi-physiological solution doesn't seem to work. He's undergoing a ventricular fibrillation. Nurse, Deborah, come and help me, please. His potassium level is too high. Replace it with 2% glucose solution with insulin, calcium, and sodium bicarbonate.
I'll tend to it right away.
Thank you. He's in your hands.
All right.
Ah, the whaling station.
What's wrong with me?
What are you talking about?
Doctor, is that you?
Yes, it's Dr. Colden. Tell me what happened.
It's the old whaling station. See?
What did you
what
see
happened?
There?
Nothing. Nothing at all. The floor was all rotten and I fell straight through.
And that's how you broke your back?
Perhaps. No idea. Passed out.
Mrs. Sanders?
She dead. She's dead. More sleeping pills.
What is the boiler room key doing here? The key to the boiler room. Not where I expected to find it.
Or close these.
Intoxication from breathing organic vapors.
Well, we were able to help one patient.
Dr. Colden, here you are at last. This patient was again brought up to the psychiatric wing. We've been following the treatment you prescribed, but the dysgeusia persists and he's lost a great deal of weight. We haven't been able to move him. The stress makes him hyperallergic.
Sir, I am going to examine you. Do you understand? Inject him with a dose of pentobarbital, intramuscular, so that I can conduct the clinical examination. He bit his lips so much, they're still bleeding. White froth, evidently because of such drooling.
Or fucking rabies.
His binds left bloody wounds.
So, doctor, what should we do with this patient?
Those basement brutes tied him up too tight, and now he's hurt.
I keep trying to heal his wounds, but he reopens them.
Do you have a diploma as a nurse?
Excuse me?
So take care of this man.
I don't know subtlety.
It's a quiet little town. Days go by, steady as ever. I wanted more for myself, but...
Yeah, you'll be fine. Hey, Bradley.
Ethan.
Marie, I...
What are you doing here?
I'm waiting for my medication, of course. Why?
Tell me your symptoms.
I have headaches. And I can't sleep.
Do you suffer from insomnia?
No. Look, I don't want you to laugh at me.
Ethan, if you don't trust me, then who?
I have nightmares. They keep me awake every night. It seems stupid, I know, but they're terrible.
Actually, you're not the only one.
No. No one has ever seen the things I see. It's like I'm turning mad.
Well, it seems
so
like an affliction.
So many people have this affliction. It's like an epidemic.
Do you think it might be related to Fuller's work?
I don't know yet, but I will figure all this out. Everyone in Darkwater is suffering from nightmares.
Really?
We don't have any medication left.
Oh, there's no excuse then. I should let you work.
Take care, Ethan.
You too, Marie.
I don't get why they have us waiting so long. Almost no patients here.
Well, we did have someone almost fucking die.
Where did my fiance go? I hope those nutcases will stop burdening her with work.
Nurse.
Dr. Colden. Do you want something?
Should probably see if there's anything back here I can use. Nope. Lockers? Nope.
In theory, this is where we hang the key to the boiler room. Dr. Fuller always keeps his key with him.
Dr. Colden, we need you at once in Dormitory B.
What is the problem?
Mr. Evans seems to be having trouble with his IV.
I've done an exam. Deborah is looking after him.
And the family of Mrs. Harding is asking to see her medical file.
I'll never understand why it's so hard to see patients' files around here.
Rules are rules. See, with Dr. Fuller, he's in charge. Anyhow, they're still waiting, and I don't think they'll leave until they get what they want.
Understood. Anything else?
As a matter of fact, yes. A man has been brought up from the basement.
I saw him, yes. It's always the same thing. They bring them up, without any explanation, with a multitude of self-inflicted injuries. We take care of the wounds, and then they leave. Each time, I feel like I'm sending them back to hell.
Their affliction is not our responsibility. You cannot save everybody, Doctor.
I beg to differ.
This man, Edward Pierce, his file is incomplete. What did Fuller do to him?
The file is strangely complete and the detail on treatment is not given. It does not respect standard practice. Might be useful to read. Do you have anything else for Mr. Edward? Sorry, itching. Hold on.
Sorry, but nobody can take anything until I finish the inventory. Please, the fewer interruptions there are, the faster I'll be finished.
Okay. Go ahead and close
please,
the door.
Please, the fewer interruptions
okay,
there are.
Okay, close the door. Okay, fine.
The operating room is never accessible after an operation. Let's hope I can go through the administration office.
We should be able to. There's something else I feel like I'm missing.
No, you're pulling my leg. I'm not joking. I saw the schedule. She's alone in the bathroom again. And she still says nothing to that old witch, Donovan.
Oh, listen to the way you talk, you naughty girl. And the answer is no. You can imagine that she doesn't dare say a thing. That silly goose lets herself be trodden on. Oh well, at least we won't have to clean for a while. And just wait and see the next time the water's cut off. It's a real show.
Well, that's mean.
The doses prescribed by Fuller are far too high.
Yeah. Romo Delinquente. The pseudoscientific works by Cesare Lombroso correlates an individual's morphology with his criminal predispositions. The seriousness of this study and the accuracy of the demonstration can deceive an uninformed reader. Ah, fake science, got it.
We've been waiting to be restocked for weeks.
Yeah.
We're running out of this medicine.
I know, Doctor. We sent the purchase order, though, and Mrs. Donovan refused it.
Once again.
Why?
Can't you do anything?
Donovan takes her instructions directly from Dr. Fuller. I'm afraid I can do nothing about it for the moment.
I mean, we can. I can get in Dr. Fuller's office in a little bit. This very interesting book, aimed at a wide public, demonstrates how non-recognized sciences have influenced modern medicine. Magnetism, grandmother's secrets, Chinese acupuncture, hypnosis, herbal medicine, alchemy, and many others have contributed, to a certain extent, to the enrichment of medicine at the beginning of this century. Well, considering we're just Pierce in another body, I wonder if we're getting the experience.
Watch out for the water, Doctor.
Thank you, sir. Can I get in? No? All right. Well, such is life. Oh, fish dude. Hi. Does that mean I did a complete circuit without even realizing it?
Dr. Colden?
Hey, doctor.
Gentlemen, may I help you?
We're waiting on news regarding our mother, Maureen Harding. She came in with a kidney problem, but we haven't heard anything since.
I'm sorry. Dr. Fuller is a very busy man.
Well, is there anyone else who can tell us what's going on?
She's our only family, you know? And we can't even see her medical file.
I'll examine her myself.
I'm aware our institution is not always welcoming. But your mother is in good hands. I'll tend to her myself. And keep you informed at once. Would that suit you?
Well, that sure sounds great to us, Doctor. Thank you.
But those are just words, so we're not budging.
Very well. At least I'll know where to find you.
Kitchen. Food? Food. Is that pizza? Soup. I doubt there's anything
Patients
especially useful in here.
Patients and hospital personnel eat the same food.
Oh, no, that's just rancid. I would never eat anything that came out of something like that. Like, look at that. It's disgusting. It looks like it hasn't been cleaned in years. Ugh. So we gotta find Miss Harding. Where would she be at? Kidney problem, huh? Kidney. Where would that be? Over here, maybe?
Ah, so there's Harding. She's still sleeping. Given her file, a nephrectomy would have been inevitable. But Fuller was able to save her kidney.
Okay. Well, we gotta get into Fuller's office now because, well...
So, Doctor, have you been able to examine our mother?
I saw her. She's fine.
I've tended to her, and I have good news. Her blood analysis is reassuring. Her kidneys are as new.
Are you talking about the same person? This is miraculous.
She's still recovering, but you may speak to her upon her awakening.
Oh, thank you so much, Doctor. We'll wait for her to wake up. We've been here since this morning, so it won't make a difference.
Sounds good to me. All right, bye. Oh, boy. Achievement. Hippocratic Oath. Heal all the patients. Sweet.
Everybody
so there's the administration.
She's a witch, an old hag. I didn't make this up. And I'm the one who pays. What a pest. It's so unfair.
So you have an interesting story. What's this? Where does this go? Oh, this just leads... Was I over here?
Everybody says it. Okay. She's a witch, an old hag.
Yes, yes, yes.
I didn't make this up. And I'm the one who pays. What a pest. It's so unfair.
All right.
Elizabeth?
What's going on?
You all right? Why is this room in such a state?
Because, as always, I'm cleaning it by myself. And the water was once again shut off this morning. I had to bother Mrs. Donovan again, giving her a new excuse to belittle me.
Do you really need Mrs. Donovan to open a valve? Why not ask the janitor?
I can't make these decisions without her approval. Imagine if there were a leak. Anyhow, the boiler room is locked half the time. So every time the water gets shut off, I have to go and endure her reproach until she's settled the problem.
I see. Courage, Elizabeth.
Thank you, Doctor.
I guess we're going to administration. Just gonna start shutting doors now. They don't have an excuse to come grab me later. Anything over here? No? Yes? No? Where does this go? Oh. Doo-doo-doo. Reference Book of Medical Sciences. Like a dictionary, this work references in alphabetical order all the medical sciences known and practiced in the modern world. For each of the entries, the major's works, and the names of the reference authorities are listed. Oh, wow. Can't even control him in the slightest. I think that's Dr. Fuller's office.
I have little time for you, Doctor. You'll find out that it's not only the doctors who have things to do.
You know what? You're
right.
Wait
a minute. Here. Where do you think you're going? Dr. Colden.
Mrs. Donovan.
Nobody goes into Dr. Fuller's office. But rest assured, I'll tell him you came by.
That won't be necessary. Thank you.
I will tell him, nonetheless.
How am I going to cut off the water? Oh, that's right. Boiler room. Okay, so... Oh, well, there you go. I've just got to get back over here. Other way, but I forgot there was another way. The boiler room key was over at that desk. All the way over there. I'll be taking that thing.
The key to the boiler room. All I have to do is shut off the water and hope Donovan takes the bait.
Oh, she will. Unfortunately, that'll mean, Miss Elizabeth gets in trouble, but hey, we have bigger fish to fry right now. It would seem she's used to the annoyances. So, boiler room, boiler room, boiler room, boiler room. Right here, yes. Aha! You. Look at this place, bro. There are flies.
I can't shut this with my bare hands. I need a tool.
It's always something. Well, I know where to find a tool. Where would you find a tool?
The operating room is never accessible after an operation.
How annoying. Ah, go in here now. Wrench, got it. Thank you, spot hidden.
I feel guilty about Elizabeth, but I need the diversion.
Poor Elizabeth. She's gonna hate us.
It's temperamental, if I understand correctly.
Dr. Colden, might there be a problem with the water?
I was about to mention it. It seems it's been cut off yet again.
I can't take this, Marie. I feel I'm gonna burst.
It's not your fault if we have defective plumbing.
And yet, I'm the one who gets punished because I'm gonna have to square off with that annoying old witch. Courage, Elizabeth. Here we go. And hold your tongue this time.
Oh, no. I'm sorry, Elizabeth. I had to do it. I had to do it to you. I'm so sorry. I feel so bad. You're gonna be hated for the rest of eternity.
Mrs. Donovan?
I'm busy. Elizabeth, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
last. The missing files must be hidden here.
Yeah, we don't have time to dick around. We gotta find them. Like, now.
Something is wrong with these masts. It's some sort of puzzle.
Ah, I see. You want them all to face that way, to the bow.
I've unlocked something.
Got it.
Patient files.
Sarah Hawkins interview. The cylinder was hidden inside Fuller's office. He recorded his thoughts about one of the many psychoanalysis sessions he submitted to Hawkins to. There's patient files. Okay. Here. I'm not leaving this office yet.
The Stendhal syndrome. Of course. This is where Fuller found his diagnosis for Francis Sanders.
A study of the Stendhal syndrome, a particularly rare mental illness. Subjects display mental disorders linked to an exposure to works of art. Okay. I feel like he'd have something hidden in these drawers. Uh-oh.
I should go another way.
Oh no. So we've searched his office. I'm able to.
Conclusions, session number 17. Patient, Sarah Hawkins. The patient appears to have finally accepted the illusory nature of what she calls the mythos. It goes without saying that these peculiar delusions are the price that comes with her exceptional gifts.
This finger belonged to a woman. Why keep it here? Why does Dr. Fuller write psychological reports about Sarah Hawkins?
At first, I presumed that her blood was the key. But I found nothing to explain Mrs. Hawkins' abilities.
The poor souls downstairs are not Fuller's only subjects.
Then James came. Irate that Charles was keeping secrets from him. I presume that he will try to break into the basement sooner or later.
That's a shoe.
I am prepared.
Hawkins, Fitzroy, and Fuller. What is the connection between these three?
It is definite that I had the presence of mind to set the morgue in the basement. When all the fuss about the Hawkins incident finally comes to an end, I will dispose of her belongings. time, they must remain hidden in plain sight.
Why is Ethan on medication? Of course. Sarah Hawkins is the connection.
Yep.
I must go back to the basement.
Yeah, now we can leave, yeah? Uh-oh.
I should go another way.
Uh-oh. We're gonna get caught. Oh boy. So we gotta go down in here. Okay. This is slightly worrisome. I doubt Dr. Colden's going to be coming up from this basement. I highly doubt she's going to be coming up from here. My prediction, death by monsters. Is that blood? That's an arrow made of blood. That is an arrow made of blood. Oh dear. I don't like those sounds. Those sounds are bad. Hello, Dr. Fuller.
Ah, now that's the Marie that I know. I knew I could count on your scientific curiosity. It's time to show you what you were so eager to discover.
Ah. What did you do?
If you're gonna shoot me, at least have the decency to look me in the eyes.
Turn around. Slowly. Talk, filthy thief! Oh, I swear I'll shoot!
It was Charles Hawkins.
Take a minute to look around. Everything points to Charles Hawkins.
He's dead!
No. He was here for a very specific item.
Oh, no.
The book. Why was it in the safe?
Have you read it?
Answer the question.
How foolish of you. Now you won't be able to escape his will. What did it show you?
Whose? Oh, no.
She went into Fuller's office. She was looking for Sarah Hawkins' corpse.
Sarah Hawkins, you say? Let's go back to the start, shall we? Whose life did the Necronomicon choose to show you?
Dr. Colden. She was at the Riverside Institute. She's in danger. I have to go.
Wait! No one knows the occult better than me. You might need my help.
Okay.
All right.
Sure.
All right. I might need you after all.
Perfect. Let's meet later at the Hawkins Mansion. Now go! Rescue the doctor!
Scholar of the Institute.
Thank you, Drake.
Accept his help. Okay, so back to the Riverside Institute. Unfortunately, I don't have a gun. So even if I do manage to get somewhere, I'm going to probably die.
Lovely.
Hello, Crow. Caw-caw. The book projected Pearson at the body of Dr. Colden. The detective watched helplessly as Bradley's friend carried out her inquiry. Confronted with the experiments of Fuller, she got into his office and discovered that the director of the Riverside Institute was hiding information on, if not the body of, Sarah Hawkins. But she was discovered by Fuller. Pearson must save her before it's too late. Oh dear me, this is not going well. Listen, Miss Colden, was it? Yeah, listen, Doctor. I'm not going to be able to save you. If this is a timed mission, there's no way in hell I'm doing it. I need a weapon. I need a weapon. Hey, we're coming back, this time as a detective and not as a patient. Did we just sneak in through a window? No, that's the front door.
I pray that Colden is really here and alive.
Oh, yeah, that was a window. Pick it. Pick the lock. Hash Life, Volume 1. Hey, I found it. The Diary of Reverend Wickock's Wife. Her husband, John, built the first Hawkins home, called Hilltop, at the end of the 17th century. They're among the first white colonists of the island. Previous evidence disappeared mysteriously.
Old diary.
Uh-oh. What was that? Ah, hello.
The Scylla is here. Like in the vision. Colden came this way. What the... Fuller, too?
Doubtful. Can I hide in here? No? Okay. What was that? See, I'm not so scared now as I would have... Would I read the book? Yes. Yes, I would. I would love to read. Mother's Bestiarum, Volume 3. Oh! Complete Revelation. Rare achievement. Read all the books of unholy knowledge. Hey, there we go. This collection catalogs and classifies creatures that I'd never heard of. Divinities from the stars, creatures capable of traveling from one dimension to another. It presents itself as the reference book on the bestiary of the myth. Without giving details on the mythology to which it refers, its pages are covers with fantastic lore illusions. How is my occult suffering? Ooh, boy, that's not good. I need six. Six? Two. I'm a detective, so I will detect. Whoa.
Right.
Stealthy about this.
Enough time wasted. Colden needs me. I must find her. I wanted to see him about
something. Best thing. No!
What the fuck?
My God. What is happening to me?
Was that the Shambler again? Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. I can't do it again. I can't do it again, man. Oh no. Okay. Okay, we got this. Just keep heading forward.
What was that? It's as if I'd been transported somewhere else.
Huh?
What happened? Something has changed, but what?
Everything. Here. I'll give the game one thing. It's fucking awesome. Oh no. Guy's gone. Uh-oh. Oh, that's a new symbol. Hello. All the patients are gone. Oh, book. This very interesting book, Into the Wide Public Demonstrates. Yeah, okay. Read that earlier. Now, the Shambler doesn't really scare me too much. It's more the fact, oh, that's bricked off. Oh! It's all bricked off.
Seen this symbol.
Oh. Okay. Right here. No. That is the right symbol. It is over here. What the fuck? Ah, that would explain why the Shambler's still after me. Fuck it. I'll murk the bitch ass. I'll fucking kill him again if I have to. He doesn't scare me. That's a lie. He scares me a little bit. I'm going to do my best not to die because I don't want to give other people nightmares. Oh, hidey hole. There we are. I was wondering where you went. Okay, so it's gotta be something. Like, I know for a fact he's gonna come after me, but I gotta figure out where I'm going first. Gotta figure out what it wants me to do. I can't just keep going wandering aimlessly. At least if I know where not to go, then I can do trial and error and just get past it. Yeah. Grr. Rah, 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 rah. You don't fucking scare me. An annoyance, nothing else. Ah, book. Easy there, buddy. Easy. Oh, maybe I'm supposed to shine it at the symbol? Well, shit. And now... Is that back at full? It is back at full. Nope. That doesn't work. I'm sorry, I am supposed to shine it down on this symbol? Ah, there it is. Ah, hello, Leviathan. Don't worry. It shall be done. Give me just a few minutes to find another lamp. Oh, can't go that way. Oh. Not through here. In through that way. That. See, I know what you're trying to do, but it's not scaring me. It's more annoying me than anything else because I don't know what to do. Oh. Maybe I just need to stop being an idiot. Maybe that's a thing. I know I can be a bit stupid sometimes. Oh, hello. You motherfucker. My eye. Oh boy. Okay, so I gotta find that symbol again. It's gotta be a thing. At least the door's open. So we got that. It's gonna be somewhere. The symbol is gonna be around here somewhere. As it is. Eventually, I'm gonna have to give up. You know, not yet. You know, I've never thought to look at the ceilings. The ceilings hold the key. Where'd I put my lamp? Ah, there you are. Thank you. We're in here now. Rah, rah, rah. Just stop being a bitch, will you? Annoying little cunt. Should probably open this door. Now where am I? Okay. Let's point to this. Ah, light.
Destiny, it has trapped you.
Well, you know. Doo-doo. I'm not climbing in the bottle of soup. Hope you realize this. Okay, detective, relax. It's not that bad. Rawr, rawr, rawr. You give it up. Fucking annoying cunt. Okay, so gotta find another place. I hate puzzles. I really, really hate puzzles. Now, what door did I open? Ah, this way. That's what it was. Yeah, it's over here. It's leading me to, which is an egg. Okay. Is there a door I can open or anything to interact with over here? Or just a place of growl, growl, growl. Is anybody seeing things? I'm not. I could just be losing my mind. An egg-looking symbol, but I don't know where to look for it. Something over here. Ceiling. Wall. In here. I kind of wish the Shambler would come. Give me something to do. So I can wander around aimlessly. Shit. It's boring as hell. I've got to be missing something. Come here. Growl, growl, growl. Will you shut the fuck up? Jesus Christ. Don't scare me, you just annoy me. Oh, stop it. You're fine to say. Oh, rawr, rawr, rawr. Shut the fuck up, Shambler. Nope. My lamp is running out of fuel. Over here? Above me? What was in that room? I don't see a way to get to that room. Nope. Gotta tell you, this is slightly annoying. It just keeps growling every time I get near to that door. It's more annoying me than anything else. He's just out of sight, and I know he's fucking there. I want to fight him, but I can't. I'm a fucking idiot. Hi, Shambler. How are you? Hey, there was a hidey hole back here. There was. I don't know how to kill him. But I know I have to go over here. Hello. Mr. Shambler came and said hi again. I don't like that he said hi. He annoyed me, and that's not scary. They're not giving me any way to... You know what I just realized about this section? You can't even hide. You're just going in a linear pathway that you've got to find the little pieces of the puzzle to. Now, what that probably means is that A, the Shambler cannot actually hurt you, and B, it's just going to be layered with a couple jump scares. So, not really worried about it. Like, yeah, he's coming closer, but if the last, like, 5 minutes taught me anything, it's that he can't actually do anything because it's scripted. Yeah, I know I do. It's fine. I'll be going there. It's over this way. Monsieur Shambler. Now, I want to test something. There should be a hidey hole nearby. Because if I can't get in the hidey hole, then it means my suspicions are correct. Where are you, Mr. Shambler? Where do you want me to go? Still blocked off. What the fuck? Guess I'll go get the other lantern. Treadmill game? What's a treadmill game? Alright, let's go get the other lantern. Unless there's something new. Which I don't think there is. Nope. All right. Ah, yes, right. Gotta go back around.
You are confronting powers that surpass you.
Hey, Drake. How you doing, bud? Nice of you to try talking to us. And I said, let there be light. Where's the way to save the game without, you know, just autosaves? If I do die, then it's gonna be a long trek back. Oh, be quiet, you. Huh. Yeah, that's fair. Wait, where's it going? Where are you leading me? It's not the tension that's worrying me. It's the fact that if I do die, I'm going to lose so much progress. And that will infuriate me to no end. And if I do lose progress, I'm just going to stop playing. At least for now. This way, here, here, and Sim. Oh, what the fuck? Okay, so it's on the other side of here. Oh, hello, door. Where exactly are you wanting to go? You just fucking... Eventually my thing is gonna run out of light and I'm just gonna be fucked. But you know what? I don't rightly care. Rah, rah, rah. I feel like it's on the other side of this room. I see what's going on. It's gonna kill me once the light runs out, isn't it? Okay, I see how it works now. I see how it works now. It only gets me when the light runs out. It gets me when the light runs out. The light runs out a continuous level. Which is why, as I go on, the growls get louder. He's right outside my vision. He can't get me unless the light runs out, but the light does continuously run out. It's on the other side of this wall. Which I can't fucking get to. Gotta find a way in there. Son of a bitch. I'm already halfway gone with my lamp. It's more than slightly annoying. Oh, come on, man. Really? What the fuck do you want from me? That way it goes into the other room. Yeah, the thing's gonna get me again. But before I die this time, I am going to find the fucking place that I need to go, if it kills me. I'm getting so tired of this shit. Growl, 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 blah, 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 blah. It refills my light. Coming in here. Fucking bastard. I can try, but I don't think it'll do anything. I keep forgetting where the portal door even fucking is. Oh, there you are. Office again. Well, there's one. There's that. There was another. Was that misremembering? No, only one? Okay. I don't know where to find that one. I will say, the Shambler is just pissing me off. It's not even scary, it's just pissing me off and giving me a headache. Speaking of headaches, one second. Sorry about that. Let's go grab my fucking lantern. I will say, it keeps getting longer and longer away. Which I assume it means the monster can get closer and closer and closer. Let's go. Gotta go fast. Not gonna be running out of space here. It's not a thing I'm gonna allow to happen. Oh, motherfucker. Oh, motherfucker. Where are you? Well, hello, Shambler. How are you? I will admit, that scared me a little bit. That made me jump.
It looks like things are back to normal.
Oh. Okay. Well, that was pointless. Now what are we doing? Ah, yes, saving Dr. Cole. About the whole fucking reason I came here. I will say, why the fuck would you put a pointless section like that in? Because that just annoys me unless the Shambler's gonna come back. Like, if the Shambler's gonna come back, fine. But stop being annoying. Okay, last place we saw her was in here, so we're gonna go in here. Where's my light? Oh, great.
What's going on? It never ends.
Thank you, Captain Obvious. Thanks for stating the fucking obvious. I'm just gonna start looking in the doors. Hello.
Damnation.
It's me.
That's me.
Oh God!
Close your eyes, take a deep breath, it's gonna be okay. You're fine, Pierce. Relax, it's okay, bruh. I heard the Shambler again. Either that or I'm just going insane in real life.
I found her. I finally know what's going on. You must live. And find the truth. It is already too late for me.
Well, don't say that.
What's going on? Was it a hallucination?
Well, no. Kill him. Kill him.
Please take a seat and be quiet, Mr. Pierce. I'll be with you in a moment.
Stop whatever the hell you're doing and turn around now.
Well, sorry, Dr. Colden.
It can't be.
No! You son of a bitch! What did you do to her?
I wish I could have done more experiments on you, Mr. Pierce.
I said, what did you do to her?
You shouldn't be sorry for your friend. You should envy her.
Murderer! This madness must stop!
Kill him. Kill him. Pull the trigger. What?
Colden?
He fucking got away. You little motherfucker, get your ass back here. So I can kill you myself. Oh, joy of joys. Alright. Time for true madness. Oh, not even controlling my character. Okay, that's great. Cutscene time. You know, Pierce, if you have a gun, why can't I use it? Do you realize what a bullet would do to some of the people we're dealing with right now? Hello, Cthulhu. I'm gonna have to stop soon. I'm actually getting a headache. This game needs to... Well, that wasn't there before. You know, with all the whispers, I keep thinking, 1, 2, Freddy's coming for you. Well. I know I'm supposed to be serious, but I really don't. this is just fun. I'm not that scared anymore. Granted, it's slightly terrifying at the jump scares, but, you know, such is life. What have they done to you?
What did they do to you?
Sarah Hawkins is alive. And she's gonna kill herself.
Gave him the
achievement, the curse
eye,
of Sarah.
The Azure. I don't see him very often anymore. The green is stronger.
Are you feeling ill?
I'm here, but no. No.
Let's get you out of here.
It comes in my dreams. Our minds melt like colors on a palette.
Come with me.
It's of the oldest green. Violent living, vibrant. A sea green, maybe. No. No.
Mrs. Hawkins, we must go before someone finds out.
Oh, but he will. He always knows these things when it's about me.
Are you saying he's making a list and checking it twice? What the fuck? Did we learn old speak when I wasn't paying attention? Fuck it, let's do it.
I've seen the same color. It was not as vivid as you said.
A pale copy. A discarded spawn.
Do you know what it was? Tell me.
I can't. We should not call his name. Terrible.
Thulu or terrible Dagon?
Terrible consequences.
Or Hydra.
All right.
Which one?
Come with me.
He will know.
Deep Sugar
he off? Will find us.
One more reason to hurry.
Have I seen you before?
Can you walk?
Maybe.
Then let's go before your husband finds us.
I guess
it
she's
was
gonna
in your
lead us
studio.
Out.
What?
You painted me. That's where you saw me.
Of course. The men in white are coming.
No.
You mean the guards?
This way. Follow me.
Okay. I'm following. What, you want me to go first?
What the?
Oh no.
This way.
Run.
Come out of your hiding hole.
Run. Run, Sarah. Run faster. I didn't... How did you get in front of me?
The machine. It's the green. The decaying one.
The gas?
Yes. It's not good.
She fucking teleported ahead of me because that bitch was not in front of me. Only the fucking means. Guards were.
We don't have time for that.
I am not moving until the wrong is set right.
Okay, fine. I'll break the gas valves. Jesus fucking Christ, woman. You're so needy. What are you going to do? How am I supposed to break the gas valves? I don't have any tools. Eh?
I'd be better off finding a tool.
Of course you would. Of course we would. Now, can I level? How many character points do I have? 2? Oh, joy of joy. We can now find everything and we can pick every lock. Such is the good times.
Perfect.
Oh, hi. Tool. A poker? What are you gonna do with a poker? Oh, just break. Oh, that's lovely. Yeah, cause.
All right. That should do it. Let's move.
You know what's good about the gas? When it. Hello, Charles.
Where the hell do you think you're going, woman?
Do you have time to speak to our Lord and Savior Jesus?
Bastard!
I think he'd be a much better deity than whatever the fuck you're worshipping,
you're
Mr. Tentacle Man. Though,
wife.
I suppose if you're into
you
tentacles.
Owe me obedience.
Leave her alone! We're leaving this crazy island.
Just punch him out, Pierce.
You are going nowhere.
Don't Where did the fire come from?
My wife.
Ow. Hey, hey, hey. I'm not into tentacles, thank you very much. Stab him with the poker.
Nobody tells me what to do with my...
Ow. Ow.
How dare you?
Ouch.
No! Why should I let you take her away when I could snap your neck?
Because there's fire?
All you did for her safety was throwing her in this rat hole. I hid her well enough. You let Fuller play with her! Stop! I did everything I could to protect her. But her identity, her power, is what threatens her.
What?
Sarah has seen things, has made things you can't even begin to imagine. Would you still save her if I told you that she is even more dangerous than I am?
I mean, she hurt.
It was her magic. The bookstore.
How do you know that? It does not matter. Sarah has been in the presence of the myth for too long. Even if she were to leave Darkwater, she would still hear his call. And the cult will always be here, waiting for her.
I mean, you could just kill all the cults.
We get rid of it! Members.
Yeah, Pierce has the right. Pierce has the right idea.
You are out of your league, detective. They control the whole island. She will finally surrender to his power, and the world will fall with her.
I mean, that's kind of contrary to what you're just saying.
No one can escape the wheel of destiny, they say. But
destiny
will change it. I will save Sarah.
If you want to save Sarah, then help us, fuck. Stop. Letting her loose. Oh, but she just stabbed... Oh, yeah, he's fucking dead. She just stabbed him through the throat. Go, Sarah. Fucking murked his ass. Where did you find an axe? Seriously, Pierce, where the fuck did you find the axe? Because I couldn't see it. Just made an axe appear out of nowhere and fucking stabbed him. Jesus, man. Chapter 9, Hawkins Mansion. After the death of Colden, Pierce, victim of hallucinations, a.k.a. fucking shambler, advanced inside the Riverside Institute to the point of discovering Sarah Hawkins, alive, prisoner of Dr. Fuller. The last confrontation between Charles Hawkins and his wife has revealed that the man, under his monstrous appearance, tried to protect her from the influence of the myth. He warned Pierce, if Sarah succumbs to the lure of the occult, she will lose all free will, allowing the cult to bring its plan to fruition. Summon an ancient and evil god. Henceforth, Pierce must know more about Sarah Hawkins' intentions and find a way to protect her. Oh, Azzy, that is a terrible pun. Don't you ever do that again. That is terrible. But I think that is where we are going to stop for the night, because I am tired. And I need to go to bed. Of course, that'll happen after we save.
No parent should have to bury their child. Knowing it's me that put him there. The guilt will never go away.
I feel your pain.
I'll do anything to get him back. Anything.
Well, that's not exactly the right course of action. You're delving into necromancy
there. My work was what lured me here in the first place. It began showing me things. Things I never should have painted. Things Charles should never have seen.
What am I to you? I took care of you, saved you from your miserable life. You'll never find a man better than me. You owe me.
I owe you nothing. We'll leave now.
You're not going anywhere. You are mine.
And fire.
It's over now.
Hello, Cthulhu. How are you tonight? I hope you're doing fantastic. Please don't be upset that I killed your friend. That's going to be it for the day. What should I start putting points into? Strength? Eloquence, maybe? Or psychology? How's our sanity do? Oh, we're psychotic. How lovely. There's a secret, a forgotten secret, so old and terrifying. It's only divulged in the blasphemous pages of lost tomes, or whispered during forgotten and outlawed rituals. We're not children of Providence. You know the cruel and awful truth. And you have seen the frightening face of reality. We're fucking psychotic. How lovely. Isn't that just perfect? Yay. While Pierce's sanity is growing dangerously weaker, his increased sensitivity to the occult opens new ways for him. On rare occasions, he is now able to unearth hidden truths when he speaks to the inhabitants of the island. As with everything connected with the myth, using it comes at a cost. Our sanity? I think I know what we should put points into. But that is it for now. I don't know if sanity is fixable. It'll be fun to see if it isn't. I just imagine this poor detective is just like, fine, I'll go find a missing person. Why not? Can't be too bad. And then suddenly, Cthulhu. poor detective. Poor detective. But we shall get through. I shall force your broken mind to accept everything that comes our way. And we shall make it off this island, detective. That I promise you. But for now, it is time for bed.